What's up? I'm Keith Kelfis. We're live here at the Jobber booth at the 2024 Equip Expo. I'm really excited. I'm a landscaper. I've been running my business in Michigan for about 13 years doing lawn care, landscaping. We've done snow removal. And I want to talk about becoming 5 Mile Famous. So the number one question that people get when they're starting their business in the first few years is, how do I market my business so I can get more leads and get more customers? And when you've been in the business for a while, it becomes obvious, because when you do something and you do it more and more, you become competent about it. But when you don't know what you don't know, you just don't know. So I'm gonna talk about some marketing tips to get a ton of more leads in your business, but also to position yourself so you look and feel like a bigger business and a bigger brand than you actually are, even if you just have a tiny business and you're just getting started. So 5 Mile Famous, remember that and keep that in your mind. And I wanna start out with the branding aspect. Some people think branding isn't important or it costs too much money, but I think it's important to invest when you start making money, a percentage of your revenue, plan it in advance and invest it into your marketing and advertising. You say, we have to spend this $1,500 this month. You start planning in advance. You can do it in the winter, you can do it in the low seasons. But first of all, behind me you see this Jobber company. No matter where you are in the world or online, when you see Jobber, you automatically know, whoa, that company is serious. Whatever they're doing, even if I don't know what they are, they take themselves serious. And then as the more you see, the branding permeates your mind, you learn that they're a software CRM and they help you automate your landscaping business or any service business. The thing that impresses me the most, and it's a great example for running your lawn and landscape business, look at the way that no matter where you go in the world or anywhere online, it's the same exact font. It's a standard. It's the same exact tone of blue. There's probably 50, 60 different shades of blue, but they have a precise blue, and it's coded. It's a number. You can type it in. It's that blue. If there's a shadow on it, or if it's emboldened, that one's not. Even the positioning of the logo is precise. So if they were to outsource any of their marketing to a graphic designer, they would give them a brand style guide and say, hey, this is the way we do this here at Jobber. I want you to think about this for your landscaping business, because when you go to market your business, say you want to get big numbers and letters on the side of your trailer or your trucks, your business cards, your flyers, your door hangers, your EDDM, your website, your Facebook, your Instagram, your X, you want it to all look the same. And the mistake some people do in the beginning is called copycat marketing. They look at what other people are doing that looks good and they try to emulate it. But they don't really know why they're doing what they're doing, because they don't have brand standards and a brand style guide. So now their marketing just looks kind of hodgepodgey across all these different platforms. And now when the customer sees it, if they want to invest $20,000 to get their landscaping done, and they go to your website, well, it looks clean. But then they go to your Facebook, and something doesn't seem right. Your company looks like a totally different brand on Facebook than from your website. And they might not even be able to consciously articulate, but they're scratching their head and they're like, something doesn't seem right. Maybe I'll think I'll pass and I'm gonna go find a company who does have brand standards. Even though they can't articulate that, when everything looks and feels the same on every single platform, and the way you have, you're building a messaging ecosystem for your landscaping business. When you do that, and your bandit signs, your door hangers, your flyers, your website, all your social media, the customers feel a sense of trust. So when I talk about becoming 5 Mile Famous, well, think about this. If you're really ambitious about marketing your business and being everywhere now, omnipresent, if you really start investing a lot of money and then you find out after a couple years you learn what I'm talking about, you might be like, whoa, we blew like 35 grand and a bunch of stuff that doesn't match. Oh, we gotta redo all this. So you gotta have a brand style guide. How do you do that? You want to hire an expert who's what's called a brand transformist. I hired a guy named Chris Beltran. The dude charged me like 13 grand. I was like, 13 grand? What? But then when now we have a brand style guide and we have messaging elements. So you want to get the right font for your business. Pick one and stick with it. Right? If you use italics, use it all the time there. Get your colors. What colors for your business? You want 2 to 3 colors max. You might think all these different colors. Maybe if you're offering something, it's like like a seasonal sale. You might put a yellow or a hot pink, but sparingly. So find your two colors and stick with them everywhere. It might feel monotonous to you, but what you're doing is you're building a brand, right? So this guy I hired, you can hire a brand transformist, look for them. You can find them on Upwork.com. You might be able to find some people here at this expo, but I guarantee you, Jobber has done this when they're investing in their business and they have an entire brand style guide. So no matter where they post stuff, it looks the same. Keep thinking about this with your business. So I recently hired a graphic designer. I was updating my entire website. And they returned something to me, a sales page. It looked okay, but it didn't match my brand. The shade of green was a different shade of green than the shade that I use. I said, hey, I sent you our brand style guide when we first got started. And they were like, what do you mean? I was like, oh, I'm not working with a pro here. But I gave them my brand style guide, and instantly, within a few hours, they sent back a marketing piece of material for me, a sales page. Now all of a sudden they were my colors. So you can have branding elements. Like, you see how this, the lettering up there, it's like a fund that says small businesses are built on sweat, sweaty days and big dreams. That's kind of like a fun embellishment. You can do stuff like that in your marketing. So when you put that and you build your brand style guide, no matter where you get anything designed, it all looks the same. Now you can go and just hire people throughout the years and all the marketing looks consistent. So become 5 Mile Famous next. Once you get that down, invest in the bandit signs, the door hangers, the flyers. The really big businesses are probably making the same exact margins as you are. They're just doing way more marketing. Some people get really upset and discouraged if they're like, man, we passed out 2,500 flyers and we only got a couple jobs. Well, what if you did 25,000 of them? It's completely different. Next thing, when I started my business, I was broke. I didn't have, like this guy right here by the camera, this dude, he probably spends like 25, 30 G's a month on marketing, right? But, so I was broke. I was posting everything on social media, anything I could do for free, over and over and over. So you might be like, why would I create a TikTok if my customers aren't even on there? They're probably not. We study and reverse our engineer our customer avatar, the socioeconomic strata. They're like in their 60s. One's a doctor, one's a lawyer. They live in this type of house. They might not be on TikTok. But if you study search engine optimization and you read books by R.L. Adams, like SEO Black Book, you should go on audible.com and listen to that, and SEO for Bloggers in the book called Reputation Repair. These books will blow your mind and you can become a pro at search engine optimization. So now when you hire people, like I have an SEO guy on upwork.com, that can enlighten your whole brain on how to do search engine optimization. Why? So you appear in time in the Google 3-pack. So when any customer is searching to, they want to drop 20 grand on landscaping and they want to hire some to do their lawn, or for us, that we do window cleaning as well, they're going directly to Google. That's 83% of our leads are coming from Google. So if you're buried on page 7, then it doesn't help at all because you don't understand search engine optimization. If you read the book SEO Black Book by R.L. Adams, it will blow your mind. And now you can start doing a lot of your SEO yourself, like starting your own blog. So if you have a website, start a blog, and then write a monthly blog article. We write about a blog article a week, an SEO-rich, 2,500-word, well-written blog article that's user-friendly, that's real. Don't just type in a chat GPT and be like, oh, I can just brrr, because the Google bots and the crawlers can tell when something is written by a chat GPT. You want it to be authentic, and then you want to email it to your customers. Anybody here do email marketing? Yes, raise your hand, email marketing. Steve does, you do? Okay, good, so every single customer, even when we're on the phone with them, we're getting their permission, all their contact info, and their email, it goes into a list. And we're emailing them like repeatedly and regularly. You're staying in the back of their mind. There's all types of follow-up sequences, and it used to be a customer has to hear about something 7 times before they decide to make a buying decision. Now it's as much as 31 times. People are seeing 10,000 ads a day. So if you keep hitting them with ads from every different angle by starting a Facebook ad budget campaign, doing it on Instagram, you can take these customers' email lists and upload them into Facebook, and now you can run ads that follow them around social media. If they've even visited your website, you can put tracking cookies and use the Facebook pixel and follow them around with your ads. This is freaking crucial right now because the competition is so fierce. So if you talk to the people that are crushing it in their business and their marketing and their 5 mile famous and they're omnipresent, they're doing this. But if you don't have the time because you're running your business literally 70 hours a week and you're exhausted, how are you gonna run your business, do the billing, the invoicing, the bookkeeping, and wear all the different hats and spend time with your family? You can hire virtual assistants. We have 19 virtual assistants, and I found them all on Upwork.com. Dude, we have a virtual assistant that does video editing, thumbnail, graphic design. I have a virtual assistant that runs Pinterest, a Facebook ads guy, a Google ads guy who can run Google and YouTube ads. If you go to Upwork, you can find these people and hire them for a couple hours a week. And now, within a few months, your ads are all over the place. And I keep saying 5 mile famous because why would you run ads completely outside of the geographic area that you're not doing business in? You permeate a 5 mile radius over and over and over and over and over, it physically and virtually, so your customers feel like you're everywhere. Like, oh my God, this company is everywhere, but you're just 5 mile famous. So you don't have to spend a lot of money to become 5 mile famous. You're just doing it to the customers that you want near you, okay? And the next thing I wanna say with that is, imagine yourself doing this, and in like a year from now, you're like, whoa, we built an entire media and marketing team inside of our service business, but they're virtual, and they help market our entire business. How did we do this? And it just becomes normal to you. Go on Upwork.com. And another thing I love about Jobber software, it obviously does the billing, the invoicing, the payment collections, the customer follow-up, the routing, the scheduling, everything. I meet so many people in person that tell me that Jobber completely changed their business, whether you're just getting started or I have a friend who's like a $15 million business using Jobber, and he says it upgraded his whole identity of his business. So become 5 mile famous in your business. If you don't have a CRM in your business, you have to get one. We're in the future. All your competition is using it. They're basically gonna smoke you if you don't have a way to automate, because it's like hiring AI virtual employees who take a ton of pressure off your shoulders. You're feeling overwhelmed, stressed out, bogged down? I know how you feel. I've been running my landscaping business 13 years, and one of the number one things that helped me was Jobber software. It freed up so much time because everything became digital on my phone. Billing, invoicing, payment collection, you could do it all with Jobber. If you want to try a totally free trial of Jobber software for 2 weeks and get a huge discount with my exclusive link, go to getjobber.com/Kelfis. Just go there and click the link below. Try it. You'll love it.